What's up, logical people? This is Amar. 8 persons need to speak at a function in random order. What's the probability that A speaks before B and B speaks before C? So we are interested only in the order of A, B and C. We don't care about the order of other 5 persons. For example, this is a valid sequence where A speaks before B and B speaks before C. I'm thankful to Mr. Babu Ram who shared me this question on Facebook. It was asked to him in an interview at a software organization. I highly encourage all of you to share as many questions as you can on my Gmail or Facebook and contribute to this logical community. Feel free to pause the video and think logically. I was able to solve this problem with 2 logical approaches. Of course, there's a mathematical solution to it using formula, but I personally love the logical approaches. So let's discuss all the 3 solutions one by one. And as usual, I'll start solving the complicated problem with a lower value. So logical approach 1. Consider only 2 persons A and B. The number of possible sequences in which they can speak is 2 factorial, that's 2. What's the probability that A speaks before B? That's simply number of valid sequences divided by total number of sequences. That's 1 by 2. Now consider A, B and one more person X have to speak. The possible sequences are 3 factorial, that's 6. So here are the 6 possible sequences. Now the probability that A speaks before B is equal to 1 by 2. Let's compare these 2 cases side by side. When there is only A and B, total number of sequences are 2 and the number of valid sequences is 1. Now, the person X joins the arrangement but his order doesn't matter. So he can speak before A or between A and B or after B. This gives us 3 valid cases. Similarly, the other invalid sequence will give us 3 invalid sequences. Observe carefully that the proportion remains the same in both cases. So the probability is also going to be the same. That's 1 by 2. Now let's consider only 3 persons A, B and C. Possible sequences 3 factorial, that's 6. We have to find the probability that A speaks before B and B speaks before C. There's only one such valid case. So the probability is 1 by 6. Now consider 2 persons X and Y join the arrangement whose order doesn't matter to us. 5 persons, so the possible sequences are 5 factorial, that's 120. Based on our previous case, we know that to have the same proportion, each sequence on the left side should map to 20 sequences on the right side because 120 sequences divided by 6 sequences is 20. That means the valid sequence on the left side will be mapped to 20 valid sequences on the right side where A speaks before B and B speaks before C. For verification purpose, I have listed all 20 valid sequences in this case. You can pause and take a closer look. So even in the right side case, the probability remains 1 by 6. What we conclude here is, we can ignore all the persons whose order doesn't matter and calculate the probability based on persons whose sequence matters. That will make the calculation much easier. Here is a quick calculation based on 8 persons. Still the probability is going to be 1 by 6. Second logical approach is much easier in terms of calculations. Consider only 3 persons A, B and C. Number of ways A speaks before B and B speaks before C is only 1 and that's simply A followed by B followed by C. Now consider 4th person X joins the arrangement. He can speak before A or in between A and B or between B and C or after C. So the number of ways will now become 1 times 4. These 4 ways can be represented as here. Now, suppose the fifth person Y joins. He can be placed in 5 ways in each of these 4 arrangements. So the total number of ways has now become 1 times 4 times 5. The same way, when 6th, 7th and 8th person joins, the total number of ways will become 1 times 4 times 5 times 6 times 7 times 8. And for 8 persons, the total possible arrangements are 8 factorial. So the probability that A speaks before B and B speaks before C will be equal to number of valid arrangements divided by total number of arrangements. That's equal to 1 by 6. Finally, the mathematical approach. Number of ways A, B and C can be arranged is 8P3. Permutation actually covers all the possible orders of A, B and C. For example, A, B, C, A, C, B, C, B, A and so on. But we are interested only in one sequence, that's A speaks before B and B speaks before C. So instead of permutations, we have to consider combination, which can be applied to one particular sequence. The remaining 5 persons can be arranged in 5 factorial ways. So the probability of this valid sequence is number of valid arrangements divided by total number of arrangements, that's 8 factorial. Using simple combination formula, cancel out the common terms and the final result will be 1 by 6. Hope you guys enjoyed. Please like and share the video, and if you are new, please subscribe to my channel and stay updated with a new logic every week. Till then, give a try to these brain teasers. Also check out interview riddles on my channel, Logically Yours.